إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يقول المولى عز وجل في كتابه العظيم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار نعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من النار. The beginning, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, when you have to mark something to guide you all the time and all of the sudden you don't find this mark, it makes you sad. Only now I noticed our muezzin, the one who passed away, our mark here. And I don't see this mark today, I was surprised. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward him the Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept him in the highest level in the Jannah, inshallah. Allahumma aghfir lahu warhamuh. Allahumma aghfir lahu warhamuh. Allahumma aghfir lahu warhamuh. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Holy Quran, إن عدة الشهور عند الله 12 شهرا في كتاب الله يوم خلق السماوات والأرض منها أربعة حرم ذلك الدين القيم فلا تظلموا فيهن أنفسكم. We are in the month of Rajab. And if we like to talk about the month of Rajab, definitely we need long time. Just we're gonna take a small summary regarding the month and the best in this month. It's the time that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam come up with the beautiful thing is our salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he talk about the month of Rajab and the describe of the month of Rajab from the scholars, they call it Shahrul Asam, silent. No sound of a weapons in this month, no fighting. One of the beautiful months. But today we don't see that except in all Muslim countries, the fight still going on. So we don't follow our deen. This is number one. Shahr al-Asam, Shahr Rajab is a beautiful month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ask everyone to just pray. Come to Allah, even the Jahiliyyah before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they taking care of this month beautiful. Better than the month of Ramadan. But they call it, at this time, the sadness news for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the month of Rajab. When his wife, Khadija radiallahu anha wa ardaha, passed away. He was so sad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Jibreel alayhi salam, when he speak to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the four best ladies would be in the Jannah. One of them is Khadija, radiallahu anha wa ardaha. And what do you think about Khadija? She's the one who believed in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he got the message from Jibreel alayhi salam from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She is the mother of the second one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised the Jannah, the daughter of Khadija, the mother of Al-Hasan wal-Husayn, the wife of Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu wa arda, Fatima al-Zahra. And the third is Asiya, the wife of Fir'aun. And number four, Maryam, Ibnat Imran. These four women, they've been the highest level in the Jannah. So Khadija, she has a value. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala promised her the best place in the Jannah. When Jibreel came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Khadija in the bed for the last moment in her life, and he said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah yuqri'uka as-salam wa yuqri' Khadija as-salam. A message from Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala to the beautiful woman, the greatest woman, our mother Khadija. She passed away. He feel lonely, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not only that, no one can touch Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when Abu Talib, his uncle alive. Then Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala take his soul too. He has no place to go. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he say, I'm moving from Mecca. I'm going somewhere else. So he moved to At-Ta'if. And he tried to talk to the leaders of At-Ta'if. Try to let them come to the Islam. They make fun of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not only that, they let the child throw the stone on our beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is bleeding. And he's asking Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. He said to Allah, I became very weak. I have nothing to do. If this is a punishment because I did something, I will accept it, Ya Allah. Jibreel alayhi salam came right away with the angel of the mountain. He said, Ya Rasulullah, this is the angel of mountain. If you need this mountain to be collapsed on them, we will do. What did he say, sallallahu alayhi wasallam? They are jahil. They don't know, Ya Allah. Nobody guide them. See how is the mercy of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But Jibreel came to him and said, Ya Rasulullah, ask. He didn't ask anything more. He made dua for them. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel to tell him, wa duha wa layli iza saja. Ma wadda'aka rabbuka wa ma qala. Wa lal akhiratu khayrun laka min al-ula. Wa lasawfa yu'tika rabbuka fatarda. ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى ووجدك ضالا فهدى ووجدك عائلا فأغنى. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah never leave you alone. He was an orphan and he taking care of you. You was alone and loose and he gave you Khadija. You are poor and the money of Khadija was in front of you. Allah will give you a lot. While he's sleeping, Jibreel alayhi salam asked him to wake up. It's a wake up call from Allah. It's a gift from Allah for the Isra and Mi'raj. Isra and Mi'raj is the beautiful journey to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. While he's taken from Mecca to Bayt al-Maqdis, سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله. A beautiful gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If the earth gets sad and the people upset you, Ya Rasulullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you al-habib, he need to see you. Al-Buraq was waiting for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with Jibreel alayhi salam. And he went to Bayt al-Maqdis, he prayed, and then he went to see and meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first door of the sky, they asked Jibreel, who is with you, Ya Jibreel? He said, Muhammad, Aja'a bin Nubuwa. He already got the message. He said, yes. They opened the door to meet his father, Adam alayhi salam. When he saw him, turn to the light and smile. Turn to the left and he cried. Oh Jibreel, why he smiling when he look at right? Why he cry when he look at the left? He said, the right, he look at his people who's entered the Jannah. He's so happy. And then the left, the people who's been in the hellfire, wal'iyadu billah. And then he go to the sama'i dunya, al-thaniya, to see Isa and Yahya.
The third, Yusuf alayhi salam. The fourth is Idris alayhi salam. Five is Harun. Six is Musa alayhi salam. They all welcome Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when we tell the salam to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when we visit in Medina, he's answering your question. He's answering your salam. When he says salamu alayka ya Rasulullah, he will reply back. So they are alive. Yes, they did, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them the soul back again to answer you. That's our witness. When the Prophet died, he's still answering. He talked to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sama'a al-Sabi'a, his father Ibrahim alayhi salam. In his journey, he saw a lot. But Jibreel was guiding him until he reached al-Bayt al-Ma'mur. And he saw 70,000 angels. They pray and they leave, and the other arrive, they never come back. Imagine the number of the angels. Imagine this number, 70,000 a day. Until he got closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Jibreel said, here is my limit. I cannot cross. The light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let me get burned. It's for you only, ya Muhammad. It's for you to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the 50 time prayers. Today the 5 time is hard for us. Imagine if it's really 50. Between the negotiation, and he cannot negotiate, Allah accepted from him, Muhammad and Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, back and forth, decrease it to 5. But imagine, we still pray 50. Al-Hasana b'ashr, the good deed by 10. If you pray your 5, you still get the 50. If you do it sincerely as the way it is. We learn from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But he take him to the Jannah, to see what is there. And he saw a lot in the Jannah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He took him and he saw his Hawd al-Kawthar, burl in the side. This is for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Can we get a sip of water from the hand of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from Hawd al-Kawthar? This is a gift for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He saw beautiful houses. It's so beautiful things there, waiting for all of us, waiting for the people of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, waiting for us to get the shafa'ah if we need it from him, waiting to enter the jannati Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The salawat that he came back with it, it's for all of us, it's a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's not punished. Your salah, your wudu', it's a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cure you from all the disease. The wudu take all the germs away from you. Then you come to your prayers, a beautiful exercise if you take it as a gym. It's all gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the worst part, when he sees some part in the hellfire wal'iyadhu billah, and we saw the angel of the hellfire wal'iyadhu billah, the Rasulullah said he's face is scary, but he gave the salam to Rasulullah. And he saw shagarat al-zaqqum, ta'am al-athim. It's the food for the disbelievers. It's in the base of the hellfire wal-iyadhu billah. And the head of it, karu'us al-shayateen, it's like a head of the shayateen. That's how it looks, hard. He saw people sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they have a hand, piece of metals, coppers, just they cut their skin and their faces. And they said, oh, brother Jibreel, akhi ya Jibreel, what is it? He said, ya Rasulullah, those, the people who talk about the others, backbiting, they don't care about the others, they walk in the earth, and they talk about him and her and there, that's how they are. And they saw people, the same thing, they cut the lips. He said, ya Habibi, ya Rajab, what is it? He said, those are the a'imma, the people who guide, who give the advice, but they don't do it for their own. يَأْمُرُونَ النَّاسَ بِالْبَرِّ وَيَنْسَوْنَ أَنفُسْهُمْ. They invite you for the bell to do the good deeds, but they talk, but they never do it by their own. And they saw people swimming in the blood, and every time they try to come out, the stone dropping their faces and their head to come down again. Who they are, Jibreel alayhi salam. He said, those are people who's eating the riba, the interest. It's just an example. That's make him sad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then when he returned to the earth, and he prayed with all the prophets, went back, people make fun of him, and the only person they jump to it and talk, the best friend, the best companion of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Abu Bakr, your company, Muhammad, he says so and so. He says, أَقَالَهَا Muhammad, did he say that? فَقَدْ صَدَقْ. From there we call him as-Siddiq. And you're proud by yourself. You pray in the masjid by the name of as-Siddiq. As-Siddiq, he trusts Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam without any negotiation. He believes in him. That's Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The message for all of us today, as-Salaah, 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 tanha anil fahsha'i wal munkar wal baghi, ya'idhukum la'allakum tadhakkaroon. As-Salaah can take you away from all the bad deeds. As-Salaah will protect you and your family. But today, as-Salaah is not number one in our life. Money come first. We're in the month of Rajab. And the dua of Muhammad and his companions, Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa balighna Ramadan. O Allah, make barak in the month of Rajab and the month of Sha'ban, and let us the witness of the month of Ramadan. Who can guarantee his life? No one. Are you ready to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Ask yourself. No one, include me, no one. No one is ready. We're all sinners. But we need to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to study the seerah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he saw the Jannah and the hellfire, it's your choice while you are alive, where you like to be. In the Jannah or the hellfire, wal'iyadu billah. You want to eat from shagrat al-zakum, ta'am al-athim, or you want to be in sidrat al-muntaha with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in jannatillah. Today, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we all wish to be together in the month of Ramadan. May Allah write it for us, inshallah. What we are doing today to be together in the month of Ramadan, except the dua from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so ask him every second from now on, Allahumma balighna Ramadan. If he wrote it for you now, it will count. You will be there in Ramadan. This is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He loved the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The companions, they used to pay the zakah before the end of Sha'ban. And they said the month of Ramadan, month of ibadah, wal Qur'an, only the month of the ibadah and the Qur'an. As a believers today, as a believer today, what we are doing to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A man, he just passed away a few days ago. His son is a soccer player, very famous. After he buried his father, he was crying. He said, my sanad, my back is hurt. The one I depend on him died. I'm in a loose. When they asked him, why? You don't want to hear that, my dear brothers and sisters. He said one day he got upset from his father and he beat up his father. When he died, he cried. Too late, unless he forgive him before he die. Imagine we reach the point we speak up in the media. إِذَا بُلِيتُمْ فَاسْتَتِرُوا. If you get something wrong, hide it. Only Allah knows about it. But now we speak up in the media. Do you think when he say that, it clear his sin? He gave a message that he disobeyed his parents. إِذَا بُلِيتُمْ فَاسْتَتِرُوا. If you did something wrong, hide it. Allah will cover it if his father forgive him. But now we are proud to talk in the media. I beat up my father. Good. You beat up the hand that work hard to feed you. That's how we are as Muslims. If this is the message we learn from the Quran, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبْرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا. Not even if. Not to put your hand in one of your parents. Do you throw the parents in the street today? What kind of human being we are? What kind of human being when we see someone else taking care of them, not us? Do you think this is right? Until when we're going to do that as a Muslims? All this problem between only Muslims, the disbeliever, they don't do that. You are brothers and sisters, not too far. Go to Flushing and look how is the Chinese people working with their grand, not the father, the grandparents. Holding them, go and watch it by your own eyes. And to go in the Muslim country today, they don't have no time for their parents. Their time only in the Facebook. And to go live and share. Husband take a picture of his wife and post it. I need how many likes so I can get some money. What kind of Muslim we are? Our privacy in the Facebook, TikTok and live. I need some share. I'm still missing 3,000 shares. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. The masajid empty. The masajid empty. If the imam exceed the khutbah more than 3-4 minutes, he can punish and suspend it. This is how is the Islam today? When we're gonna learn our lesson? When we will learn that we learn the Quran and the Sunnah in the masajid? The Katatib and all the Arab people, do you know that? Katatib is a small place in the masajid with holding papers and writing on it to learn. Everyone pushed the kids to go to the masjid to learn. Today they close all of that. And we follow only the non-believers. We follow only what we don't need to know for our deen. They walk in with the red bands in all of Muslim countries today. What is it? What is it? We lost our deen because of our leaders. Because the leaders did not allow the scholar to help and teach. They put them in jail. That's why the people, they beat their parents. They forget who they are. But for you, my dear brother and sister, I give you a message. If they are alive, get closer to them. If it's not, make dua for them. Give sadaqah. Remember them. Make dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from all of us and help our parents as much as he can. Subhana rabbi rabbil izza amma yasifun. Astaghfirullah al-azim li wa lakum wa sa'il mu'minin. My dear brother and sister Islam, as we're standing together today and we are facing the month of Ramadan, I'm advise myself and all of you to come closer to the Shura member and see what they need in the month of Ramadan. If you do it today before tomorrow, Allah will count it for you. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our soul earlier than the month of Ramadan arrived, it will count for you. Come close and ask them what they need. How can I help? How we make the place as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted in the month of Ramadan? It's a lot of activities. It's a lot of problems. It's too much in the shoulder of the Shura members. Put your hand with their hands. And before
I end it. I ask you kindly, kindly, close yourself. Close as much as you can to your parents. They are the key of the Jannah. Without them, you cannot be in the Jannah. Yes, in the Day of Judgment, everyone will say, nafsi, nafsi, myself, myself. Include your parents. But Allah will ask you or me in the Day of Judgment, and sometime you will deny, say, he didn't teach me. They will deny it. So do your duty as a witness in the Day of Judgment in your book. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he gets your book, he will look at it. And the scholar said in the back of the book, all your bad deeds. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love all your good deeds, he will drop this one, he will talk to you individual. He say, Abdi, that's what you did, I drop it, go and enter the Jannah. The Jannah that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw by his own eyes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let all of us among the people who enter the Jannah. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana. كفر عنا سيئاتنا اشف مرضانا ارحم موتانا اللهم ارزقنا الجنة ونعيمها ونعوذ بك يا ربنا من النار وشرورها اللهم اجمعنا مع الحبيب المصطفى في جنات النعيم اللهم ارزقنا شربة ماء من يد رسوله الكريم لا نزمع بعدها أبدا اللهم ارزقنا شربة ماء من يد رسولك الكريم لا نظمى بعدها أبدا اللهم اغفر لوالدينا اللهم ارحمهما كما ربيانا صغارا اللهم ابعد الشيطان عن بيوتنا وعن أهلينا لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين عباد الله رحمني ورحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم وأقم الصلاة